What's going on, all you soft plastic freaks? Today we are going to shoot the Gary Yamato Senko mold, but we are going to use the laminate plate. We're going to make a laminate plate Senko. And I mean, that's basically where half the bait is one color and the other half is whatever other color you want to use. Today I'm going to shoot black and a sweet potato with black flake in it. That sweet potato, it's like an orange type color, like maybe Alabama crawl or something. Put my plastic saw in there, the softener, and there's the black. I had some leftover plastic, so I've already started heating that up, but I'm gonna put this back in the microwave again. We are gonna get this thing started. But I'm gonna go ahead and get my mold ready, since I've already started heating the plastic up. But basically what you want to do is you want to put these molds together. Go ahead and put this one in here to help stabilize it. But if you look at the way it's made, it's got the that one little metal piece where it goes all the way across. It's just a flat plate, so it's only going to shoot half the bait. So I'm going to get these lined up properly. My clamps on. All right, clamps are on. Mold is ready. Now let's check out our plastic. Got a lot of bubbling. It's about 40 degrees outside today. It's been raining. And there's a lot of humidity in the south. But I don't know if you can see all these air bubbles in there or not, but I'm about to show you guys how to get rid of them. But what you want to do is you want to let it sit right here and let it cool down for a minute, and all the bubbles will rise to the top of the plastic. And then after it sits there for a little while, you put it back in the microwave, it's going to get rid of all the bubbles and everything. But it's a key factor that you let it cool down, because if you don't, with it being as hot as it is right now, whenever you put it back in that microwave, you're going to burn your plastic. And it's going to smell and it's going to stink, and you're not going to be able to do anything with it, and it's just basically going to be trash. So we're going to sit here for a minute and let it cool down. Give it one more stir. Try to get all the bubbles off the bottom. But just keep in mind too, if there's a small amount of bubbles you see in the plastic after you heat it back up and they're not gone, the majority of the time whenever you put your, whenever you're injecting this stuff, your injector is gonna push this out, all the little air vents built into the mold. I'm gonna throw it back in here. It looks like it's starting to cool down pretty good now. I'm only gonna put it in there for about 20 seconds. About gone. Got a few left in there, not many. Give it one little stir. Alright. Now we're going to pour our plastic into our injector. Always give your mold a good tap. Any air bubbles left in it will come to the top. Keep it upright. and top it off. One thing to keep in mind whenever you shoot this laminate plate, do it mold cells under 1995. You do not have to put a lot of pressure on it. If you do and the plastic's too hot, it's going to shoot out the sides and all through the air vents. So just take it nice and slow. All right, I'm going to pull up and top off. I'm going to wait for this to cool, and I'll show you how they come out. All right, guys, while that's cooling, I have some more plastic poured, fresh plastic. I got the sweet potato orange Alabama crawl color in there with the black flakes. I'm going to go ahead and mix it up now. And I know this is a little late in the video to say this, but guys, make sure you always shoot your darker color first. If you don't, your darker color will bleed through your lighter color. Orange is mixed up with a black flake. Looks good. Alright, let's see what these look like. Keep in mind too, if these plates still may be hot. And off it comes. And see how it only did one half of the bait. So now what I usually do. I just use a handheld razor blade, and I'll come in and I'll cut it at the top of the bait. And I do each one that way, and then pull off the excess, just like that, where there's no touching, there's no moving, nothing to worry about. You can remelt that, use that again. Just make sure when you do that, you put in some Plastisol stabilizer. Now all you got to do is close this back up and put these molds together. I'm gonna throw this in the microwave for a minute. Go ahead and get this process started. I will show you how these bad boys turn out here in a second. Definitely something different. You know, a lot of people don't use these, so the fish haven't seen a lot of this stuff. I mean, I know you can buy laminate plate Senkos from the store, but of course the majority of the baits you can buy are solid colors. But I mean, the things you can do with this is just so unlimited. I mean, any color dye you can buy, you can mix colors to make unique colors. I mean, it's just, it's awesome. That's all there is to it. And if you've never tried it, I would highly recommend trying it. I mean, I've almost got to the point now to where I'd rather be out here doing this than out there in the pond or at the lake with my buddies or my dad fishing. I'd rather be here doing this. Kind of sad, but that's the whole reason I started this, was to make things that you can't buy. Well, the colors you can't buy, some of the stuff you can. All right, so it's not hot enough yet. Well, that piece don't want to be made into a bait apparently, so throw it to the side and discard it. Here my son just woke up. If he ends up coming out here and my wife lets him out here, he's He's 3. He'll be 4 in March. He sees me out here making soft plastics. He's going to come out here and want to make some as well. We'll see if he ends up coming out or not during this video. But if he does, I'm sure he'll be in the middle of it. Caught his first fish this year. I got it on video. I might put that up one day. Guys, it's about ready. Just keep in mind too, you don't have to use anything big to stir this stuff. A lot of those little digital temperature thermometers, a little prong would be great. The harder you stir, of course, the more air you're going to put in the bait, but in this situation, I think it would be all right. If not, you know, of course we know how to get rid of them now. Got it good and hot. Apparently we got a little too hot. If you look right there on the side, I just raked some of the burned plastic off of it. I'm going to try to cool it down before it ruins all this. Well, that's why always checking it is key. And I didn't do it. Has cooled down enough now. Give it one more stir. Let it sit there and cool down for a second or two because I can tell it's too hot. Way it's still steaming a good bit. Oh yeah, we are there. All right, guys. And then now, you just want to pour your plastic in. It's in there. Remember, give it a couple taps just to make sure any air that's in there comes to the top. Top it off. Give it a nice, steady, slow push. That way you give the air an opportunity to come out of the mold. Make sure it doesn't need any more top off. You're going to let this bad boy cool. We'll be right back. All right, guys, and we are back. Let's take the clamps off and let's see how they turned out. So you got your black side. And you got your watermelon crawl side. Well, not watermelon crawl. What are you talking about, Dave? Your Alabama crawl. I mean, isn't that crazy? Look at those. I mean, they look so good. Especially in dirty water, you could use these things. I mean, you can make any color you want. I mean, they're just amazing. But, I mean, possibilities are endless, like I said. You know, where can you go buy a tomato seed worm with a chartreuse tail or your old school, you know, purple with fire tails on it, or my personal favorite that I made the other day for the first time. I mean, look at that. It's a green pumpkin with chartreuse tips. I mean, that thing is absolutely beautiful. I mean, so like I said, but all you soft plastic freaks, y'all stick around, like, subscribe, share my videos. I'm loving growing this channel with you guys, so I'll be shooting some different molds and stuff, and I'm probably going to come out here in a little while and see if my son wants to make a video, and we'll let him choose the color he wants to make. But like I said, I appreciate everything. You guys have been great. Like I said, like, comment, subscribe, and join this YouTube journey with me. See you guys.